first today, we've sent Emma-Louise on an out-of-this-world mission to test drive the first ever UK-built Mars rover. It will explore the red planet in 2030 for signs of present and past life on Mars. Watch this.
Newsround sent me to some weird places, but today I'm on Mars. Okay, I'm not actually on Mars. I'm in a place called Stevenage, but it's very special here and probably as close as I'll ever get to the real thing.
This room has been made to be close to the conditions on Mars to test out this. The Rosalind Franklin rover, otherwise known as Bruno. It's part of a mission by the European Space Agency, which the UK government have helped pay for. So how exactly does it work? I caught up with Yvonne to find out more.
So this is a prototype that we call Bruno. He is one of the first models that we used to start testing a project called ExoMars. So ExoMars is a rover that looks very similar to this. It's going to be flying off to Mars to go and look for signs of life. So it's actually going to drill into the surface of Mars, pick up a little bit of like dirt and sand and whatever it can find, and then bring it up on board and test it to see whether it potentially ever contained some life.
So will this actually go to Mars?
So not this specific one, no. Obviously you can see this one is out here with all of us and all of the bacteria and dirt and everything that come with everyday life. So the real one had to be built in a facility that is possibly the cleanest place in the world.
Wow.
And that is to make sure that it hasn't actually taken any life with it.
There have been six other rovers who have successfully made the trip to Mars, but most were sent by US space agency, NASA.
So I think the biggest reason that this rover is different is because it's actually going to be testing the samples on Mars. None of the rovers previously have been able to do this.
The rover is scheduled to leave Earth in 2028 and will take 2 years to land on the planet, where it will hunt for rocks, fossils, and any other clues that might help us understand more about how the solar system was formed.
Why is it so important that we go to Mars?
We actually think that Mars used to look quite similar to Earth. Rivers will produce features on the land. And as we kind of know, all life on Earth does require water to live. Mm. So if there used to be water on Mars, there's a fair chance it maybe was able to also have life. So we're going to send our rover to Mars and hopefully discover whether anything used to live there.
Scientists hope that the findings can tell us more about whether there is life beyond Earth. And if there's a chance that one day humans could visit or even live on a planet like Mars.